On Daily Business tonight, our guest is Jerzy Bielewicz, Gazeta, bankowa writer and financial analyst. Sir, welcome to the show.
Thank you for the invitation.
You are watching this news coming from Italy about a quarantine. 16 million people under quarantine. That's the biggest zone. I don't remember anything like that in European history. Will this have consequences for Euro, for European Union's economy? And for Poland?
Let's hope that very, very short-lived. If we look at Asia, it looks like we are over coronavirus. Few cases in China, few cases in Korea. And let's hope that in Europe this epidemic would pass quickly, because Italy is the weak man of Europe economically. They carry huge load of debt, and the banking system is quite weak in this country. And here you are. They are attacked by coronavirus. The weakest country in Europe is attacked by coronavirus. It's a huge problem at this point for Eurozone and European Union. And the reaction, I wonder what would be the reaction. Germans are not that quick to support economy, to stimulate economy on a fiscal way. The European solidarity gets to the checking point, I would say, in 2020. And it's about the future of euro currency as well.
The euro currency is one thing. Another is the Polish economy. Last year we had fantastic growth comparing to other European countries. Can Poland sustain this level of development?
It will, because it doesn't depend on the situation in Europe. I think it depends most of all of geopolitical changes, about new economy, about new trade routes, about going, opening to Asia, about infrastructure projects in Poland, central communication hub, infrastructure in energy sector. We are becoming a hub, economic hub for trade, goods exchange, and that's why we are doing so well. And neighboring countries in 3C's initiative are doing so well compared, let's say, to Germany. We are expanding, they are kind of getting
stuck
in economic problems. And I would say that the situation right now with coronavirus would strengthen Poland. Obviously, there is one condition, that we would not let this virus into Poland.
And so far, 17 cases confirmed, and the spread is on. So we only can see will be the level next week, for example.
But the government is doing a good job, in my opinion. And right now, we are in quite a good position with so many hospital beds. As compared, let's say, to other countries, it's a good situation. We were talking so about Polish healthcare not in a good way.
How it's underperforming.
But it looks, like it's quite good at this point, and we can count on them.
Anyway, this is a dangerous situation for Europe, and on the economical terms, we may expect some hardships. The Polish economy used to be pegged to the German economy, and Polish manufacturing was very much part of the German logistical chain. With the slowing down Germany, why don't we see slowing down Polish production?
One secret is our currency. We are very flexible. We can adjust our currency rate, and that works very well. We are expanding on the German market at this point, which is not surprising because we have a very elastic economic system with our own currency, and our enterprises are elastic as well. Their reaction time is very, very quick, and that's the way it goes. You know, the business is in Poland, in Central Europe right now. That's where the investment is, and we can just pray that it stays this way for a long, long time. Okay. Let's say for another 100 years.
We certainly do hope that this will go on for another long, long years. Well, do you expect that the climax of this coronavirus in Europe will be in 2-3 weeks?
I think there was a research yesterday published in South China Morning Post, the short note on this research, that coronavirus doesn't like high temperatures. The best temperature for coronavirus to spread is 8 degrees Celsius. Mm-hmm. If spring comes, it would retreat, I hope.
So we all wait for spring, not only because we like flowers and bees, but also because we don't like coronavirus, which hopefully will retreat by then. Jerzy Bielewicz, Gazeta Bankowa, writer and financial analyst, was our guest. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And that was it for Poland Daily Business tonight.